Hi there, I'm Sarah Hartle, and a massive welcome to the premiere of Bad Grandpa. Tell me what it's all about.
This movie's a story. You know, it's not your typical Jackass. It's not like just a little vignette. This one has a long playing story. So it's about a naughty grandfather trying to raise his grandson.
Has this idea been in the pipeline for a while, or is it something that just came to mind like in bed one night?
Well, we started talking about this in 2006. Could we do it? We didn't talk about the actual story. We just talked about, could we spring Irving Zisman into his own movie? And then, I don't know, a couple of years ago, we started really working on the idea. So it's taken a while to develop it.
And I don't want to have any spoilers, but I mean, from going from the trailer, we have some scenes where it looks like
that little dude, right?
He's the star of this movie with Johnny, but it looks like the people's reactions are genuinely real. Is that the case? Like, you just picked a contest?
We will never show fake reactions. That's not who we are. So
talk me through the beauty contest. You must have been, like, hysterical just waiting for that moment.
Yeah, it was shocking to sit there and watch it. You know, you write these ideas and they're on paper and you think, oh, I hope we get something out of it. But, you know, we're expecting to get busted at any moment.
And the judges' faces, was that real?
Yeah, the judges' faces are. One judge knew, the one judge on the left knew, but the big reaction, she had no idea what was going on. So
I guess that's why the beauty of this film is. It's so authentic. It's so, like, real. It's in the moment.
Yeah, and there's people starring in a movie that have no idea they're in a movie, you know?
What's it like working with Johnny? Many people would ask the question, you know, what's the real Johnny like?
You know what he's like. He's not a different person than what you've seen. No, he's very much that guy. So,
what was it like working with both Johnny and Jackson?
This little guy is one of us. He's of our same, he's cut from the same cloth, so we found the perfect little dude.
Maybe they're going to be a second collaboration coming along?
Yeah, probably. Who knows? You know, you never say never.
And finally, what can the audience expect to take away from this movie?
Well, I hope they find it as funny as we did making it, because it was a ball to make. So
I'm excited to talk to you, because you're the one guy on the planet that wanted to take on Johnny.
Yep.
Why? What gave you the guts to do that?
Nothing, I just wanted to punch him so bad.
You just wanted to punch him? Well, you saw him and you just like got anger filled, or it was like a growing hatred?
My hand is going to beat on his zipper as hard as I can.
Do you actually like hit him hard, or is this jokey? Are we talking real stuff?
You'll see it at the end of the movie. I think it shows me doing it.
And I don't want to spoil it for the viewers that are watching this at home, but in the trailer, we see you like dancing, you're playing a girl. What's it like to play a girl, get a wig on? Did you enjoy that?
No.
You didn't?
It was sticky. It
stuck. Sticky?
Well, it wasn't sticky, but it stuck to me. Like, the jewels would get stuck on me. I had to go like that. My nails. Oh, wait.
I have to ask you, Jackson. How old are you?
9.
You're 9 years old.
I did it when I was 8.
You did it when you were 8. And there's a pole dancing scene.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Did you have pole dancing lessons?
No.
You didn't? So that was natural instinct?
Well, we did.
You've been watching too many films?
No. We had like a lamp where I was practicing and I had to do it on that.
Okay, so you practiced on a lamp?
Yes.
I think you've got a career ahead of you. You know, if the acting doesn't go plan, you know, pole dancing it is.
Yes.
Tell me, what do you want from the future? Where do you see yourself in 10 years' time?
Fishing.
I just don't believe you. I think you're lying to me.
You want to be fishing?
Do you fish right now? Is that what you do at the moment as a hobby?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me what you caught.
I caught a 17-pound pollock and a 16-pound striper and a 15-pound carp.
Did you?
Do you know what? I used to fish with my dad and we caught, do you know what a tarpon is? I caught a tarpon. I impressed Jackson. Did I impress you?
I've snorkeled with one.
You didn't catch it? Going up on you, little one.
I snorkeled in a sunken ship that was in the war.
Okay, I'll give you, you beat me on that. Well, it was lovely speaking to you. Finally, could you give a quick message to fans out there?
See the movie.
Da da da, or he's gonna come get ya. We see you in this movie as a grandpa. Tell me what it was like getting into character and how this idea came about.
Well, the idea's been around for a while, and getting into character would take 3 hours of makeup every day. And my makeup guys who applied it, they would just say the worst stuff the whole morning, and it really helped me. Like, however filthy Irving is, they were much filthier. and it was just fun getting into makeup with them. Yeah, yeah. Some days it was 5 hours when I wore the back and the front.
Now, I've met Jackson, and he's very intelligent, but he's kind of mean. He's vicious. So tell me,
did
anything hurt in the movie as much as his punches and his flout bullying?
You had to look. You had to have your head on a swivel because he was hitting you in the zipper every second. But I mean, he's so smart and he's so sweet. He has a sweet side. It doesn't come out a lot, but there is a sweet side. Yes, I think you're going to love this movie. You got to see Jackson. Just what he did in the beauty pageant is worth price of admission. Mwah.
Now, are you crazy? It's out now. It's, as you just said, number 3 doing really well.
I know. It's crazy. But I think it was definitely quite nerve-wracking. I think when you come into like new releases, it's always like, oh my God, please tell me people are going to like it. But they seem really good about it. So
you've got a swing version as well.
A swing version, yeah. That's the one that I'm trying to get everyone to listen to because it's really different and like a lot of people haven't heard it, and it's at the beginning of my video, but I've just literally 2 days ago released a full version of that. So hopefully people hear it and
you can catch that on iTunes.
Yeah, that's 59p. Yeah.
Who wouldn't pay 59p for you?
63p.
Now tell me through the process, you like when we first saw you, you were quite young, quite naive, and you've grown into this star that we all want to go and see in concert. So what's the process been like? Has it been strange?
It just felt like a blessing, really. No, I'm joking. I'm just gifted. No, but it's been hard. A lot of like, you know, a lot of weird moments you go through. I think a lot of like, you know, a lot of traveling, kind of meeting people, and then suddenly you leave them and you don't see them for ages, and it's kind of weird, but it's definitely been a lot of fun. I think, you know, I've kept my old friends around me, my family around me to kind of keep me, I suppose, grounded in that sense. And yeah, it's been a lot of fun.
Was there a key moment when you thought, oh my God, like this is the real deal now? This is going to be my career?
When my first album went to number one in the UK, that was kind of like that. But yeah, that was a big moment for me. I think that was probably the one where I've enjoyed the most so far. So, yeah.
Single, Are You Crazy? We all love it. Tell me, what is the craziest thing that a girl has done for you?
Say again?
What's the craziest thing a girl, not even a girlfriend maybe, but a girl in general, what has she done to you that's been the craziest thing, like outrageous?
I've been in a car chase before.
You've been in a car chase?
A car chase. A girl that I knew, one of my ex-girlfriends, she chased me in a car. I was in my car, she chased me in her car. This is back in Brighton.
What had you done?
It was like James Bond, but like I was in a Vauxhall Corsa, and so I think she was in like a Peugeot 106. It was like the in-betweeners version of James Bond. So it wasn't that cool. But yeah, that was probably the crazy thing, because I was just in the car with another girl, but we'd broken up, like we weren't together anymore. So
let's just get that straight. He had broken up, did nothing wrong.
I'd done nothing wrong.
We were on a break.
She was just chasing me in the car, wanted to kill me.
Now we're here to celebrate Bad Grandpa. You've got to be a Jackass fan.
Definitely, 100%. I've watched all three.
Like Johnny Knoxville.
I'm a big fan of him as well, but I'm scared that he's going to like jump out and prank everyone.
He's going to rock up as a grandpa.
Do you think so? He probably would. If he doesn't,
he
kind of missed a trick. But then at the same time, it would be like the opposite of what we expect, because we all expect him to dress up as a grandpa. So
this is about like Bad Grandpa. It's about really naughty and cheeky. So I have to ask, you have a face like a cherub, I think Fern Cotton once said. What's the naughtiest thing you've ever done?
Naughtiest thing I've ever done?
I'm getting in a car chase.
Yeah, that was pretty naughty. I've trashed a hotel room before.
Have you?
I did. Yeah. Kind of anticlimax. It was in Margate.
Like the Ritz.
So yeah, not that rock and roll. But I still felt pretty cool afterwards. Actually, no, I didn't. I felt really bad afterwards, actually. So I'm like the least rock and roll person ever. But I did do it though.
There's been a lot of controversy lately about like crazy performances going mental, like Miley. You know, would you ever do a performance that was necessarily shocking, or do you like to keep it quiet? You know, moving into the swing and stuff. I don't expect you to start twerking on stage, but.
Well, I just did twerking over there a second ago, so. Am I really? Oh, thanks. You're like, don't. But I don't know, really. I don't know. I feel sometimes that kind of takes the focus away from the music. I think it's a bit like, if you're an artist, you want to be seen for your music, not the crazy shit that you do. And the problem with Miley is that her songs are actually really good. Like, she's genuinely talented. So I think sometimes it's hard because it kind of like things that everyone's talking about, the craziness, is kind of like, takes away from the musical side of it. So. But I don't know, but then everyone likes to have fun as well, and I also like to have fun, so
if people see amazing, I want to have fun.
Also people blow things out of proportion as well. Sometimes you're just having fun, and like, oh my God, they've lost it, like they've gone mental. It's like, no, I'm just having fun, so.
Exactly.
So yeah.
And what can we see from you next? We've got the album coming out?
Album coming out early next year. Obviously there'll be a single before that. Oh, my book comes out tomorrow.
You have a book?
A book.
Did you write it?
Yes.
That's incredible.
Is it like a biography?
Yes. Ah. So 7 pages long. No, I'm joking. But yeah, it kind of tells how I got to where I am now, what I planned in the future. I think the real idea is meant to inspire others, okay, like people, young people my age, to kind of think, I can go and do that as well.
Final question, because I'm having fun here, but I'm going to have to let you go watch a movie. What would your advice be to young musicians trying to break into the industry? Because you've just said this book is about inspiring people, people that want to make it. What would you say to them?
Don't let anyone tell you that you can't do it. So definitely believe in yourself, that's one thing. Because when I started out on YouTube, I had hate comment after hate comment after hate comment. You've got to ignore that. Just go for it. If you want to do it, then you go for it. And yeah, just enjoy it as well. Like, keep your people. If you start working, it starts getting bigger and you get massive. Keep your original people around you, all that kind of stuff. So, yeah.
Absolutely awesome. Well, enjoy the movie, Conor. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
How are you doing?
Good, thank you. How are you?
Very well. Why are you excited to see Bad Grandpa?
Because I just think it will be really, really funny. And also, I'm a huge Johnny Knoxville fan. I used to really fancy him when I was younger.
No, you didn't.
I did.
Did you?
I got that bad boy thing about him. And yeah.
Tanya, what do you look for in a man?
In a man? Well, the guy that I'm actually engaged to is a real kind of like gentleman, good guy. But and I obviously love that as well. Love you, Jim. But I did like Johnny Knoxville. Like, I used to watch him all the time and just think, oh, that kind of bad boy thing is kind of attractive.
Now, Tanya, you are nothing short of a makeup guru in the world of beauty. So tell me, what are the essential products and tips and tricks of the trade for an evening out when you hit the town?
Okay, first things first is powder. Now, I'm probably haven't powdered enough in the cab on the way here, and you're probably going to be like, oh my God, you look so shiny, but powder is so essential. I hate looking shiny in photos or on camera. You know, when you're going with an out with your girlfriends, you're always taking pictures, and I think powder is so key for topping up, especially in like a hot club.
And they're saying at the moment that like matte red lips are coming in. Do you agree? And how on earth do you, because I would not know how to do red lips. To me, it's terrifying, that thought, and I worry about getting it wrong. So what would you do? How do you get it right?
You'd look so nice with red lips. Yeah, with your hair, it looks so cool. I would say start with a lip liner and line your lips to get a nice kind of even finish, and also put it all over your lips. I did a tutorial on this the other day, because if you put it all over, it acts as like a base and the lipstick kind of clings to it and it lasts so much longer.
Okay. So there's a tip, and that's online now?
Yeah, online now. So I think I called it like Rihanna makeup tutorial or something. It was quite like a dark red lip.
Amazing, we'll check that out. So tell me, your three products that you couldn't live without at all.
Oh, okay, NARS Sheer Glow Foundation, it rocks. Maybelline the Falsies Mascara, I have this on now, and I always used to wear false eyelashes, and now I don't, because I think it's really, really good. And brow pencil, I fill in my brows with eyeshadow, so MAC Charcoal Brown Eyeshadow, that's what I've got on my eyebrows tonight.
Nice. Now, I do believe you've got a range coming out, haven't you?
I can't speak about that yet.
Okay,
I'm sorry.
You can't speak about it, but it is coming out.
I told, and I was not supposed to tell you.
We didn't mention that at all then. We look forward to seeing the surprise of that.
You're always the first person I tell.
There we go. So when it comes out, do you promise that we can have the first interview about it?
Yes.
And maybe we can have a makeup session and we do a thing online with it?
That would be so much fun. Yeah.
Perfect. You are an absolute YouTube sensation. So I remember I went to a workshop at Channel 4 and they used you as the person to look up to for using social media and getting noticed. So what's your opinion on that?
On being a YouTube sensation? It's really cool. I mean, it's so flattering to have a lot of people watching my videos, and I just can't thank them enough, the people that watch them. I feel like I have a really close relationship with my viewers, and because I chat to them all the time on Twitter and YouTube and stuff, and so if any of them are watching, I want to say a big hello.
Talk to me about the process. I mean, how did you go from normal girl to then makeup artist to then being recognised as one of the most, you know, recognizable people in the industry of makeup?
I think I just started uploading tutorials, and just the views just grew really kind of quite slowly, to begin with, and organically, and then it just kind of snowballs, and once you have a few thousand, I guess word spreads and people tell their friends, like of other people that I watch online, I'm always telling my friends, and I guess that's how word spreads, isn't it?
We've just had Fashion Week. Is there anybody that ultimately you would love to do their makeup for that's an idol of yours? Yeah. Oh, you're getting excited for this.
Yes. Cara Delevingne. She is such a dream. I've had the joy of meeting Cara like about 3 times, I think, just at fashion events and stuff and London Fashion Week things. And she's so lovely and down to earth and beautiful. And I would love to do her makeup one day.
What is it about Cara? Because she is the Kate Moss of our generation. She's everywhere. So her face as a makeup artist, why is it so perfect for everything?
Oh, she's just so interesting and gorgeous, and I do think her personality just shines through. Like, Cara is just insane and crazy, and it just makes you want to work with her. And she's got gorgeous skin, and then these amazing dark eyebrows, really heavy, and her eyes are just, she's just amazing.
Tell me, if you're doing Cara's makeup, run me through it, would you do heavy eyes because the eyebrows, or would you mix it up a little bit?
I'd want to do a kind of Burberry style look on her because it just looks incredible on her. So like a brown smoky eye and like quite nude lips and just a bit of contouring. Yeah.
Amazing. Well, thank you so much. Enjoy the movie tonight. I really appreciate you talking to us.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you. How are you this evening? Are you excited for Bad Grandpa?
I'm so excited. When they told me this premiere, I was like, I have to go see that. I love all the Jackass stuff. I love Johnny Knoxville, and I'm big into comedy stuff, so I'm into it.
Johnny Knoxville, everyone can't help but love him. But yeah. For you, what do you like about him so much?
Well, he's actually kind of cute, isn't he?
You're the second person to say that tonight.
I think he's kind of cute. Over Jackass times, I was like, he's sexy. But, you know, and he's balls to the wall. I mean, he's outrageous, and that's fun. You know, it's exciting, and you never know what he's going to do. I'm sure we're going to be laughing our butts off.
Exactly.
So
I'm excited to meet the kid that decided to challenge Johnny Knoxville.
I know. Doesn't he dress up in drag or something for one
he
of
goes,
the...
He enters like a tiara toddler's thing and then enters as a girl and then strips off with
me, and I'm so excited.
And I've just ruined that moment for you.
Yeah, yeah. No, I saw that in the preview, so that I'm excited. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Has anyone ever played a prank on you?
I'm sure they have. My girlfriend's done a few things where she's called me and acted like she was somebody that she wasn't. But I don't know. I don't have much pranking in my world, which I'm kind of okay with.
I'd be okay with that too. It makes life easy, right?
Yeah.
Now tell me finally, what are you up to at the moment? You've had like, it's like a new chapter for your life. We're seeing so much of you at the moment.
It's amazing right now. My life is so exciting. I'm settling here in London, so I'm starting a new chapter here. Got clothing stuff. I'm the face of Key Collection, and I'm doing my music, which comes out the beginning of the year. Some really fun stuff in the works. I'll be popping up here and there on your television screen, so excited.
Hey.
Yeah.
Will we ever see a reunion with the girls again?
I don't know. You know, I don't know. Anything's possible. We'll see.
How are you this evening?
We are good. We turned up in the wrong place to start out with, but, you know, we bounced back from it. We're okay.
See, I thought you might have been one of the intelligent ones.
Yeah, I am, but I'm also extremely disorganized.
The glasses are just a facade.
Image. Well, actually, the thing is, that's why I bought Mark, because Mark's kind of the brains behind the whole operation.
The beauty in the brains.
Yeah. Well, no.
Brother Love Boys Night Out here going on.
Yeah, this is, well, obviously, Bad Grandpa, we thought a perfect night for the boys.
I was saying, are you excited about this movie? Have you seen the trailer?
Yeah, we've seen the trailer.
We've been excited about this movie for a while, actually.
I hope you laughed out loud when the boy like strips on the toddling thing. You can't help but find it slightly funny.
The girl dancing is my favourite of the trailer.
And also that in my opinion, there's something wrong with putting kids out on the stage like that at that age about being beauty. I find that weird and slightly upsetting in itself. So the fact that they make a mockery of it is just even better.
Now, I've got to ask, what are the pranks between you two? Like, growing up, they must have been pretty bad. And who's the older one?
I'm older.
You must have bullied him a little bit at times.
No, we had some very aggressive PlayStation fights. In fact, you hit me in the head with a controller once.
I won. Yeah.
You didn't.
I'm better.
You're not.
Starting an argument here, right?
Not now, Mark. Not now. Mum told us to bet.
Andy Jordan loses it at Bad Grandpa from you.
Cool. No, so... we did a lot of we're in the same boarding house at school actually, so there was a lot of like sneaking into each other's cupboards in the morning while the other one was at breakfast, and then he'd open it and I'd go, and jump out, which is always scary. And then
foam in the bed, wetting the bed.
Yeah, shaving foam in the bed, that kind of thing.
That's horrible, so classic. Now tell me, Maynard Chelsea, it's coming back, how are you feeling about it?
Well, I'm quite apprehensive actually. I have no idea what...
You not watched it yet?
So we don't get to see it. We see it right as the viewers see it.
So you'll sit together and go, oh, I hated you at that point.
Yeah, we all sit together and we watch it. And I literally, to be quite honest, I hate watching it in a room with everyone else. It terrifies me because what happens is you kind of like, particularly nowadays, like you just forget the camera's there, you forget everything's going on, and you just kind of, sometimes you're a little bit loose with the things you say about other people, and then suddenly, a couple months down the line, you're in a room watching it, and you're like, oh, did I say that? Damn it.
If anyone was going to be the prank player in Made in Chelsea, my vote would go for Jamie, but what would your opinion be? Because I don't know them, but you know, you guys know them.
I tell you who plays fantastic pranks, and that is Francis Ball.
Really?
Yeah.
I would imagine he'd do it and then play really cool. Like, of course it's not me, I'm the gentleman.
Well, actually, we went on a little boys trip recently, and he absolutely did Stevie and I. But I can't tell you exactly how it went down because I think it might be in the show. I don't know if it is or it isn't, but...
Now, finally, the question that we're all asking, and it's in the papers everywhere, so I'm sorry, but I have to ask. What's your opinion on Spencer and Steph's relationship? Did you meet them? Did you think it was, like, real? Or are you glad that they're maybe
Spencer
not?
Spencer can't keep single. Can't. Should just be single. He can't. He can't keep a relationship, so I don't...
No.
I don't really... We all know how it always ends, so... Why?
Yeah, I think it's almost boring. I think she's actually a lovely girl, and I think I vaguely remember... We were out with them. We were pretty drunk. I vaguely remember saying to her... You're an idiot.
You said that to her?
I think I may have said that to her. I can't remember because obviously she's...
You should have.
Yeah. She's going out with a guy who's obviously going to cheat on her. But, you know, it was what it was. They certainly seemed very happy with each other at the time. And I think they're still together. I don't know. I don't talk to Spencer, if I'm being honest.
Thank you for asking that. I was really nervous to answer that. And finally, we've got some new faces coming in the show, haven't we?
We do. We do. There's four new faces.
That's quite a lot.
Yeah. There's two guys, two girls. And they're a tight-knit group, actually. I think they were they all at uni? Mark knows them better than I do.
They're my friends.
Everyone's going to be tweeting you now, going, tell me the info and the loader.
No, the boys. I know the boys really well. They're good boys. Both pretty.
Did you not want a starring role in it?
No, haven't been tempted just yet. Maybe in the future. But more and more people are...
Mark
Andrew needs the airtime.
No, so basically...
He struggles about the attention.
Mark runs our business. We share a company together. Jam Industries. It's going to be a surf brand. Well, we launched two...
I've seen this, because you're a big surfer, aren't you? You're always down in Cornwall.
Yeah, we're actually going next weekend for the British University Surf Champs. And so that's what we do together. But obviously, if we were both filming all the time, then it gets quite difficult.
His ego. His ego.
And this guy's the brains behind the operation.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's the man behind the mask.